Hi guys, thank you for stopping by. Today I would like to share with you how I created this portrait. For the background, I'm using mix of titanium white and medium magenta. I'm using Liquitex brand acrylic paint. And I'm applying it on a special paper for acrylic paint, but you can use any thick paper, watercolor paper works just fine. Before you are moving to the next step, make sure that your paint is completely dried. Most of the time I work with references. So this one I found in Vogue magazine and I made black and white copy so I can refer it later on. And instead of drawing this portrait, I'm going to use jelly plate to print it on my background. I'm using jelly plate because I wanted to show you just another way of transferring image to the background. If you never did those kind of transfers before, be aware that they are not always work, and I don't know why, maybe because there are different type of inks used or paper, because some magazines, sometimes in the same magazine some images work and other don't. So don't be disappointed if it will not work out from the first try, but when it works it's really fun. And I'm using this basics Liquitex acrylic paint, which I find works the best for this kind of transfers. You will need to use about this amount of paint if you're using the same paint as me. Too much paint is not good and too little will dry too fast. Place your image face down, rub gently on the top and pull it off. Then stamp it down in the middle of the page. Gently press it down everywhere and slowly lift it up. The inspiration for this set of analogous colors was this picture from Fashion Magazine, where the model is wearing pink clothes and there is a pink background and purple shadows. On my palette from the bottom right, purple, the same I used for the printing, it's hiding over here. Then it's cadmium red, medium magenta, yellow ochre or yellow oxide, titanium white and raw amber. When we do print like that, some details are got disappeared. And it's a good idea just to go over and kind of redraw it. I'm using my darkest paint, which is raw amber, to outline her features. Once in a while, I dilute my paint with water. As you could see here, I put my brush into the water and into the paint. It is easier to draw with the paint which is not as thick. With the mix of brown and red, I go over lips and nose. Thank you. For the skin tone, I'm using pink, yellow, and white. I make from that a few values by adding more white to the mix. The lightest value from this mix I'm using for my mid-tone. Maybe it's gonna change as I go forward, but for now this is my mid-tone. This painting will go through a lot of transformation, and I'm going to speed it up from now on, because it was a few hours and I don't want you to fall asleep. I hope this video will inspire you and you're going to paint today something too. Thank you for watching, and I hope you're going to share with me in my Facebook group called Olga Fuhrman and Friends Dream Story Art. See you there!